At KVGC News Time, 7 minutes after the hour of 7 o'clock. Time now for a look at the news for a Wednesday, the 29th day of November for 2017. The news for today, both the state and the mother lode saw an increase in deadly accidents over the Thanksgiving holiday CHP maximum enforcement period. Wednesday evening through Sunday night, CHP dealt with 15 accidents in Calaveras County alone. One was a double fatal that claimed the lives of a mother and her daughter after their vehicle hit a bear on Highway 4 Thanksgiving night. Two other Calaveras County accidents resulted in major injuries, with one tied to a DUI. Statewide, statistics show a spike in fatal accidents, with 50 people killed in 41 traffic accidents, a jump from 31 deaths resulting from 27 last year during that same period. Of those killed, four were pedestrians this year. CHP officers made 1,057 arrests for driving under the influence, up from 902 last year throughout the state. The skull found during a traffic stop last week in Calaveras County could be the remains of a Native American who died a century ago. According to Deputy Coroner Keith Rosa, the skull has been sent to a forensic anthropologist at the University of California, Santa Cruz for further analysis to determine the person's sex and approximate age, a process that could take 6 to 8 months. Rosa says there were certain details on the skull that indicate the remains are that of a Native American and that there was no signs of foul play. It also appears the skull was buried, as it shows no signs of bleaching from the sun. The skull was discovered by Angels Camp police during a traffic stop late last Wednesday night. Joshua Davis of Murphy's was arrested on numerous charges, including possession of methamphetamine and disturbing or removing human remains. He was booked into the Calaveras County Jail and has since bailed out. A three-vehicle accident claimed the life of a Valley Springs woman and tied up traffic on Highway 26 for almost an hour and a half Monday evening. According to the CHP, around 6:30, Mark Lineman of Modesto was driving westbound on Highway 26 west of Vista Del Lago Drive. Wade McCann of Valley Springs was traveling westbound on 26 and stopped his vehicle to make a left turn onto a frontage road that runs parallel to Highway 26. Lyman failed to notice McCann's vehicle had stopped ahead of him and struck the rear of the vehicle. The force of the impact pushed McCann's vehicle forward and into the eastbound lane, where a vehicle driven by Valley Springs resident Rudy Leon struck McCann in the right passenger door. Barbara McCann, a passenger in the vehicle, was transported by ambulance to Mark Twain Medical Center, where she was pronounced dead. Highway 26 was blocked for about an hour and 20 minutes. CHP reports all parties were wearing seatbelts and that alcohol and or drugs are not believed to be a factor in this collision. The accident is under investigation. And the Ione Fire Department Santa Patrol is gearing up to start this Sunday, the 3rd of December. Let's get our Santa Patrol music going there. It'll continue nightly through Friday, December 8th. Ione Fire Chief Ken Mackey says he's grateful that Santa takes time out of his schedule to check in on the city of Ione and the county as a whole. A holiday favorite with children of all ages in Ione, Mackey says some of Santa's routes through the city have changed this year, but residents can check the fire department's Facebook page for a complete listing. Chief Mackey adds to look for Santa to start his nightly visits about 6 o'clock, unless, of course, there's an emergency that requires the fire department to respond. On Sunday, Santa will begin his visits on the southeast side of Ione, starting at the fire station on West Jackson Street and heading east on Jackson Street, ending up back at the fire station. Little side note, Santa will visit the neighborhoods of Jackson with the Jackson Fire Department starting on December 20th through the 23rd. And this Saturday, Calaveras Lumber in Angels Camp will be hosting a Toys for Tots drive from 1 to 5 p.m. Santa and Mrs. Claus will be on site for professional photos with the kids, as well as cookies, hot chocolate, and crafts. In return, Calaveras Lumber asks for a new unwrapped toy as a donation. All proceeds from the toy drive go directly to Toys for Tots to brighten a local child's Christmas this year. And that's a look at local news on a Gold Country Wednesday morning, the 29th day of November. From the KVGC News Center, I'm Jim Geedy reporting.